Hello, I'm Dave Inhiske, and you're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel. In the video today, we're looking at what makes pop rocks pop. Much like other hard sugar candies, pop rocks are made primarily of sugar, corn syrup, water, and artificial flavoring. What causes the candy to pop when it comes in contact with the moisture and heat in your mouth is not due to any ingredient. Rather, it's due to the way the candy is made. In a nutshell, the ingredients are first combined, stirred, and heated up, bringing the mixture to boil. They continue to boil it until the moisture level descends suitably so that a thick, syrupy substance remains. In normal hard sugar candies, this substance is then put in molds and allowed to cool and harden. However, with pop rocks, they expose the hot mix to carbon dioxide at about 600 pounds per square inch. This causes very small bubbles of carbon dioxide to form within the mixture. The substance is then cooled and subsequently hardens. Once the hard candy is formed, the pressure is released. This causes the candy to shatter, leaving small nuggets of hard candy, which are the pop rocks. Many of these nuggets still contain pockets of carbon dioxide kept at relatively high pressure. When the candy hits the saliva in your mouth, it quickly dissolves the thin barriers containing the pressurized carbon dioxide, resulting in the bubbles bursting, often with sufficient force to cause the candy to jump in your mouth. Bonus fact: Pop Rocks were invented by chemist William A. Mitchell, who worked for General Foods. He also invented Tang, Cool Whip, quick-setting Jell-O, a tapioca substitute, and powdered egg whites, among many other things. In total, he received over 70 patents in his lifetime. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like below. Also, coming up, Simon and I are thinking of doing a bit of a Q&A video, so if you have any questions for us, please leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.